The proposed 5.3 trillion peso Philippine national budget for next year inches closer to approval. Senators on Tuesday endorsed the 2023 General Appropriations Bill to the plenary, setting the stage for debates to begin Wednesday. In his sponsorship speech, Senator Sunny Angara said the proposed spending bill would address pressing problems hounding the country. He also rejected allegations some items in the budget were recycled from the previous administration.
The President has made it clear in his message to us that every peso that he seeks to spend in 2023 is aligned with his administration's thrust. And what are these? To boost growth, to cut poverty, to trim the deficit, to pare down debt, and to catapult us to the league of upper middle income nations. Our economy remains debilitated by the effects of long COVID. Although we have installed springboards for recovery amidst the rubble, the takeoff is not yet in the desired velocity that will propel us past the damages it has caused. Then there is the war in Ukraine, Mr. President, which is seven time zones away from us, but did not spare us from the fallout of fuel, food, and fertilizer crises it has unleashed. Kaya maling isipin na ang budget ay simpleng spreadsheet o listahan ng mga numero lamang.
Both houses of Congress are aiming to get the 2023 national budget signed into law by President Marcos before Christmas. Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. leads the ninth anniversary commemoration of Super Typhoon Yolanda's onslaught in Leyte Province. Survivors of the monstrous storm admit moving on has been difficult as they endure hardship in resettlement areas, Sharon Evite reports.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. leads activities marking the ninth year since Super Typhoon Yolanda hit Eastern Visayas. Marcos Jr. believes the death toll due to Yolanda is higher than the 6,000 fatalities reported.
I've questioned it from day one. I've questioned 6,000 plus, ang sabi nila. It's not 6,000 plus.
If you remember, during the count of the casualties, the count was stopped. And we knew that there were still thousands out there.
A separate tribute was given by the police in Paloleite, who offered a mass inside their headquarters in Camp Ruperto Canglion. The president also spearheaded the distribution of aid to various sectors there. More than half a decade after their ordeal, Yolanda survivors continue to face difficulties. The latest one, a cholera outbreak in their resettlement site in Tacloban City. The Tacloban City Health Office recorded 601 people stricken with a waterborne disease. Five have died. Some Yolanda survivors also decry the slow pace of identifying the casualties by government. Victims argue it's hard to move on if they can't properly honor their dead. Some families have no choice but to put tombstone in a mass grave just to give them a place to gather every Yolanda anniversary.
Kasi sabi, after 1 year daw yung result. Pag 1 year ng Yolanda, nag-ano kami sa kanila kung may result na, sabi to ano pa daw. Kasi mahirap ma-identify. Pero until now, 9 years na yung Yolanda, wala paling result.
With the unpredictable nature of disasters and the need for government to prepare and swiftly deliver aid after a calamity, President Marcos wants to put the National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council under the office of the president. This, he says, will help the disaster agency become more responsive.
Can only do more in terms of actual bringing the assistance, putting the infrastructure together, making sure that the LGUs are functioning, that there's communication, that there's power. This can be done if now there's the NDRMC, and they are the ones who are tasked to do this, but I think it would be equally, if not more, robust a system if we put it under the office of the president.
Before visiting Leyte, the president was in Antique, which was recently hit by severe tropical storm Paeng, to distribute aid to affected residents. Residents were given financial aid and food packages, while other beneficiaries received livelihood grants. Around 43,000 families were affected by Paeng.
Asahan po ninyo na lagi po kaming nandyan kahit di nyo po kami nakikita. Pagka merong ganitong bagyo, at may mga naging biktima ay alam po namin ang mga pangyayari at ginagawa po namin lahat.
Overall, the death toll from Paeng in Western Visayas has risen to 36 with 6 still missing. Sharon Avita, ABS-CBN News.